Many patients you see will have been affected by the environment where they live, work, and play, but the environmental factors are not visible or obvious when the patient presents. For example, an asthma exacerbation case seen in the ER is related to exercising in an area with air pollution. To investigate this, use an exposure history using the mnemonic CHOPD, CH2OPD2. C is for community. What was the health risk from air pollution that day or on the preceding day? The Air Quality Health Index, or AQHI, for communities across Canada can be found online at airhealth.ca. Was she exercising outdoors, thus increasing minute volume and pollutants delivered to the alveoli? Was she exercising near a busy road or an industrial smokestack? Is it allergy season? H for home. Are there indoor allergens, for example, a new cat or dog, cockroaches, mold from a flood in the basement? Is there a wood stove or fireplace with particulate matter? Or are they using a poorly vented gas stove for cooking, releasing nitrogen dioxide? Might there be off-gassing from a new carpet or indoor painting? Is someone smoking environmental tobacco smoke? H for hobbies. Is she affected by off-gassing from glues, solvents, or paints? O, occupation or school. There might be poor ventilation with buildup of dust, mold, cleaning products, etc. in the school. If she is working, there are many occupational exposures that might exacerbate pre-existing asthma, and also sensitizers and irritants that can induce new asthma. P, personal habits. Is she smoking? D, diet. Is this an allergic reaction to food, for example, nuts or shellfish? D2, drugs. What prescription, non-prescription, and alternative medications and supplements does she take, or in the case of a child, might be available in the home? More detailed forms for a full exposure history are available.